I wanted to touch bases again about our last conversation. I feel like ever since we've moved to this house, I have felt so much animosity from both of you. You come in, you give me dirty looks, you're unkind to me. I say something and you're talking about me behind my back. I feel like you guys are my enemies, that you're against me, that you're trying to hurt me.
I would say for myself, that's not accurate.
Part of my challenge is I do feel insecure around you guys. And I think it's probably something that a first wife might deal with because I chose you, Arlie, to come into this family. I picked you, I welcomed you, and I received you. And we've had our challenges. And I chose you, Angela. But for me, on my end, there's no security to know that you would choose me.
April wondering if we would choose her as a sister wife, of course we chose her. We chose the whole family. But if you want a friend, you need to be friendly.
If tables were turned and you were the first wife, I don't know that you would pick me. And it seems very likely to me that neither of you would.
I don't feel understood as the first wife in my family. It's really easy to complain and to find faults, but I don't feel like they're putting themselves in my shoes.
That insecurity kind of colors a lot of the interactions that we have, where I'm constantly hoping to get that in some form, and that need has never been met.
Yeah, that was never the issue. That's kind of an aside. That doesn't mean we get to escape the consequences.
When April says we wouldn't choose Ho, it's a way of deflecting the situation and to make us feel bad. Basically, if we loved Ho and understood Ho, then everything would be better.
I've felt a need to protect myself because of what I view as manipulation.
I would love if we could get to a point where you could say, it doesn't make sense to me, but I know April loves me, I know she has my interests at heart, and to have that trust.
I don't have that trust.
It's clear you don't have that trust.
And it doesn't matter what the rest of us say. You took it into your hands and manipulated the situation so it would tone out the way that you thought was best.
And you know, we could go back and forth all day on these details. The bottom line is that I've been avoiding you. And I have not been having the best of feelings towards you. I'm actually really surprised how quickly downhill things went once we all moved in together. I really wasn't expecting that. And I have wondered, what have I gotten myself into?
I don't think I can progress anymore in this conversation.
So I would like to kind of...
I just need a minute, okay?
Can I say one thing?
Just...
Hey, Sunshine.
Hi, what's up?
Just come and see how you're doing. Since we all moved in together, our home is in total chaos. It's challenging to have three wives who have emotional, mental, physical needs. It becomes very difficult to get in the middle of all these disagreements. You know, I try and keep myself as separated as possible so I can just help them reconcile instead of exacerbating the problem, and sometimes I fail. Just trying to organize all the stuff that I'm bringing back from the law office. And then since the AC's been broken, I've been trying to fix that.
I feel like you've had so much on your plate, and I haven't felt like I've had a chance to really touch bases with you or kind of connect time.
And yeah.
It's like...
Doing more than living right now.
Yeah.
Totally get it. So what have you been thinking about?
Mostly I'm really feeling unsupported, you know. I just don't like the dynamic of Angela complaining to you about me, Arlie complaining to you about me, and then you coming in and trying to problem solve with me. I don't like it because I feel like that is hurting my relationship with you.
I understand.
You yeah. and I are having a phase in our relationship where we haven't been as close as we have been in the past, right? Mm-hmm. We haven't been in the best place.
I haven't felt like that Drew has been really aware of me or the dynamic that I've been experiencing, and I just really like him to understand better.
Part of the issue here is Arlie has felt from the very beginning that you've acted like you're superior to her.
I feel like that maybe you know me well enough to know that's not in my heart.
If anything, I felt the exact opposite of that, you know?
I'm not taking sides.
I've been the lowest one on the totem pole, but Arlie's at the top, and then Angela, and then me. You're giving them a lot of energy and a lot of time, and whatever's left over, that's what I get.
So I know that there's been a lot of tension between the three of us, and I was hoping that we can find some kind of resolution.
Yeah. So, I have really been examining my heart, and let me tell you that you two are dead wrong. That is not who I am. I'm fed up with this thing that you do of imputing motives to me that are not true. And it is a lie that is hurting our family.
I was taken by surprise when April told us that we were dead wrong in our perception of her. I completely froze, like Arlie tells me she does.
I want you two to know I love you, but I'm not gonna stand by and let this kind of thing go on anymore.
This time, April's very aggressive about it, and it seems like she's doing it that way to make sure this conversation goes the way that she wants it to go.
I think right now, it would be great to all come up with one thing that we can work on for ourselves to be better and create change.
If you just said one thing nice to me every day, or just some
April,
encouraging thing.
I really want to keep this about being accountable for ourselves and not demanding something from somebody else.
I'm not demanding.
Or even asking.
No, there's nothing wrong in asking. I just want to see you for who you really are. And I think if there is some kind of word of affirmations, I think that would make me feel like things are steady.
I think I can work on trying to remember to say words of affirmation.
These types of conversations with April are completely self-serving. Her agenda is to get her way and for us to drop our issues. And so even if it was nothing but for self-preservation, I will say let things run completely your way. Because if I tried to do anything else, it's just hope.